Assalamu alaikum. In this video we are going to create a crane hoop pulley block assembly. In our previous uploads we are creating a individual part diagrams of the crane hoop pulley block assembly with reference to this bill of materials and assembly view diagram. We are going to assemble the components here. Assalamu alaikum. First we have to open a new file assembly, then click OK. Here we are going to insert a component which we created previously. So browse our component where we save. Now we are going to insert a pulley. So select a pulley and click open and place it at an equal position. Then we are going to insert a few more components. So go to the insert command and browse it. Now we are going to insert a push. So select a push and place it at an equal position. We have to apply the mate between the push and pulley. So go to the mate selections. And then you have to select a two internal faces to apply the concentric mate. After that you have to apply the coincident mate. After selecting coincident mate, you have to select a two flat faces of the pulley and a push. Then we are going to create a two number of pulleys here. So we are going to use a mirror components. So just exit the mate selection, then go to the mirror components. In your drop down list of patterns, after that you have to select a midplane of pulley and mirror the push about the midplane of pulley and click OK. Now that we have created two number of pushes here, after that we have to insert a few number of components. So go to the insert components, we have to insert a pulley pin. So select our corresponding component and click open. Now we are going to a mate selection. We are going to apply the concentric mate between the pulley pin and a bushes. Select a two corresponding faces, outer face of the pulley pin and internal faces of the push. Then we have to just align the pulley pin to the corresponding position. After that we are going to apply the advanced mate here. So select the advanced mate. Inside the advanced mate we are going to apply the width mate. After selecting a width mate we have to select a four number of faces. We have to first select a two faces in a pulley pin. Then we have to select a two faces in the pulley. Select a two faces in the pulley by zooming it. After selecting the two pieces in the pulley pin is occupy the corresponding position by the width mate. Then click OK. There is a slot in a pulley mate. We need to download the slot to the corresponding position. So just you can rotate the pulley pin. Then we have to apply the mate between the two planes. So go to the mates. We have to select a two corresponding planes to apply the parallel mate. One plane is at the pulley, another plane is at the pulley pin. After selecting the two plane, we have to apply the parallel mate automatically, then click OK. Now the slot is at the downward position here. So just exit the mate selection, go to the insert component, we need to insert a few more components. Browse our corresponding component, we have to insert a cover plate here. So place a cover plate at the required position. Then we need to apply the mate between the cover plate and other components. First we have to apply the concentric mate between the cover plate and a pulley pin. After that we need to insert a few more components. So go to the insert component. Now we are going to insert a lock plate here. So select the corresponding component of the lock plate and place it at a required position. Now we are going to apply the mate selection. In a mate selection, we are using advanced mate here. So select the advanced mate instead of standard mates. After selecting advanced mate, we have to select a profile center mate. Select a profile center mate. Then we have to select a upper face of the lock plate and the slot face of the pulley pin here. So just zoom out, select the pulley pin slot face. Now the lock plate is occupy the corresponding position here. After that, we have to apply the mate between the lock plate and a cover plate. So select the corresponding faces. Select a face in a cover plate. Then we need to select a face in a lock plate. Now the cover plate is occupy the successful position. Then we need to insert a few components. Go to the insert component, browse it. Now we are going to insert a distant bolt. Select a distant bolt and place it at required position. Then we need to apply the concentric mate here. Just to show the all axis systems, go to the mate selection. Select a coincident mate and select two internal axes of distant bolt and a hole in the cover plate. Then click OK. Now the coincident mate is applied successfully here. After that, you need to apply the coincident mate between the flat faces of distant bolt and cover plate. We have a 4 number of distant bolt here, so we need to mirror the distant bolt. Select a mid plane in a cover plate. Then we are going to the mirror component in a drop down list of patterns. Select our distance bolt to be mirrored, then click OK. Now the distant bolt in another side is created here. After that, we need to insert a few more component. Select a M20 nut here. So just click open and place the nut at a corresponding positions. Then we are go to the mate. We are going to apply the coincident mate between the distance bolt and a M20 nut. After that, we need to select two faces in a cover plate and a nut to apply the coincident mate. Select a corresponding face in a nut. Now the nut is occupied correct position here. We have a 8 number of M20 nut in a component here. So we need to just mirror the bolt one by one. Select a corresponding mid plane in a cover plate and go to the mirror component and select a M20 nut. Then we just mirror it. Now the 2 number of M20 bolt is created here. Remaining 6 number of bolt we are creating in future. So just insert the component. Now we are going to insert a distant bolt. Then click open. Go to the mate selection. Follow the same procedure which we do previously to mate the distance bolt with the cover plate. So select the both axes and apply the coincident mate. Then we need to select two flat faces in a distance bolt and a cover plate to apply the coincident mate to occupy the correct position. Then we need to mirror the components. Select a mid plane of the cover plate, then go to the mirror component. Select a distance bolt to be mirrored. Then we need to insert a M20 bolt. It is not a bolt, it is nut. Then we have to make the distance bolt and a nut. Select the two center axis, apply the coincident mate. Then we need to select the two flat faces in a M20 nut and a distance bolt. Apply the coincident mate between them. Then we have to mirror the nut here. So select a mid plane in the cover plate, go to the drop down list of pattern and select a mirror component and select our M20 nut to be mirror. Then click OK. Now the 4 number of M20 nut is created here. In future we will create a remaining 4 number of M20 nuts. After that go to the insert component and browse it and select a M16 bolt. We have to create a mate selection. Go to the mate. We have to assemble the M16 bolt into the lock plate. So select a two center axis of the M16 bolt and a lock plate. Then we have to select the two flat faces in a M16 bolt and a lock plate to occupy the correct position of the lock plate and a nut. Now the M16 bolt is occupy the correct place in a lock plate. Then we need to mirror the lock plate by selecting a mid plane in a cover plate. Go to the mirror component and just you need to select a M16 bolt to be mirrored. Now the distant bolt and the lock plate we are created successfully here. After that you need to go to the insert component and browse it. Then we have to select a cross head block here and place it at a required position. We are going to apply the concentric mate between the lock cross head bolt and a cover plate. Then click OK. After that we are going to apply the coincident mate between the cross head block and a cover plate and select two flat faces correspondingly. Now the cross head block is occupied successfully correct position. Then we need to browse our components. Click open. We have another lock plate. This lock plate is have to occupy the position in a cross head block. So go to the mate selections. Select a parallel mate. You have to select a two parallel faces here. Then click OK. Then we need to advanced mate. Inside the advanced mate we have to apply the width mate. Inside the width mate we need to select a 4 number of faces, 2 number of faces in a lock plate and 2 number of faces in a cross head block. Select a 2 number of faces in a cross head block. The width mate is applied here. Then we need to apply the tangent mate between the cross head block and the lock plate. So select a standard mates. Inside the standard mate we need to select a tangent mate. You just select a cylindrical face in a cross head block and flat face in a lock plate to occupy the tangent mate. After that you need to apply the coincident mate between the cover plate and the lock plate. So select a two flat faces in a lock plate and a cover plate. then click OK. Now the lock plate is occupy the correct position here. Then we need to insert a component. We are inserting the M16 bolt here. Likewise, previous method, we have to apply the mate in between the lock plate and a M16 bolt. Select a two center axis of the lock plate and the M16 bolt and apply the coincident mate. After that, you need to select a two flat faces in your lock plate and a M16 bolt to apply the coincident mate. Now the M16 bolt is occupy the correct position in the lock plate. After that, we need to select a mid plane of the cover plate. Otherwise, you can insert a component of the lock plate another time, or otherwise you can mirror it also. Now we are applying the mate successfully here. Then we are going to mirror the all components with the corresponding to the mid plane of the pulley. You have to just hide the center axis of the components. Then we need to select a mid plane of the pulley. Then go to the mirror components in a drop down list of patterns. Now we are going to mirror the cover plate bolt and nuts here. So select a bolt and nut, lock plate, cover plate. After selecting the all components required to be mirrored, then click OK. Now the all component is successfully mirrored here. After that, we need to insert a crane hook. So go to the insert component and browse the crane hook and place it at a required position. Again, we have to go to the insert component and select our corresponding components. Now we are going to insert a component such as a nut. We have to apply the mate between the nut and the crane hook. So just show the axis systems. Then we have to go to the mate selection and select a both axis of the nut and the crane hook to apply the coincident mate. Then click OK. After that, you need to select a center axis of the hole in a crane hook and a center axis of the hole in a nut to apply the coincident mate. Then click OK. After that, we are going to insert a bearing here just to hide the axis systems. Then we are going to the insert component for inserting the bearing. Browse our component. Select a dust cover before inserting bearing. Then apply the mate between the dust cover and the crane hooks. Select a two internal faces and apply the concentric mate. Then both select the flat faces after the dust cover and a nut and apply the coincident mate. then go to the insert component. Then we need to insert the bearing here, thrust bearing. So select the thrust bearing component, click open. Now we have to apply the mate between the thrust bearing and the crane hook. So go to the mate selection. Inside the mate selection, we have to apply the concentric mate between the bearing and the crane hook. So go to the mate and select here internal face of the bearing and external face of the crane hook to apply the concentric mate. Then click OK. After that, we need to select here coincident mate. Then select here internal flat face of the dust cover and flat face of the bearing. Just click OK. Now the coincident mate is applied successfully here. After that, you need to create a mate between the crane hook and a cover plate assembly. So go to the mate and select a cylindrical face of the crane hook and a internal face of the cross block assembly. Then click OK. After applying the concentric mate, then we need to select a flat face of the dust cover corresponding to the crosshead block. Then click OK. Now the crane hook is occupy the correct position here. First we have to open. Last we are insert a last component. Go to the insert component and browse it. We have to assemble a split pin here. So select a corresponding split pin and place it at required position. We have to apply the mate between the split pin and a crane hook. So go to the mate selection. Inside the mate selection, we have to apply the concentric mate between the crane hook hole and the split pin. Select the outer face of the split pin. Now the concentric mate is applied successfully here. At last, we have to apply the width mate. So go to the advanced mate and select a width mate. Inside the width mate, we need to select 4 faces. We have to select 2 faces of the nut in a crane hook and the 2 faces in a split pin. After selecting a 2 faces in a nut, we have to select 2 faces in a split pin. So select 2 faces in a corresponding split pin. Then click OK. Now the split pin is occupy the correct position in a crane hook. You can analyze it by zoom the component. We have a split pin here. At last, we have to apply the sum of the aesthetic looks. So go to the visible of type of visible of component. You can choose it anything. Then we have to change the background for the aesthetic looks. To get the regular updates of my video, please subscribe in my channel. Don't forget to like and share. Inshallah, we will meet in next video. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe. Last